The session outline is Introduction to Behaviorist Theories. At the end of this session, you will be able to discuss the behaviorist theories of learning. Behaviorist theories are those theories which explain learning as a formation of bond between a stimulus and a response. When an organism learns to give the correct response to correct stimulus, then a connection or a bond is formed between that situation and that response. And this is called as S or bond. Therefore, all the behaviorist theories explain learning in terms of formation of a connection or an association or a bond between a stimulus and a response. Therefore, these theories are also called as connectionist theories or associationist theories. In all this kind of learning, whatever changes in behavior has happened as a result of learning can be observed in the organism's behavior. For example, one who did not know how to cycle will be able to cycle, and we can observe the change in behavior. And most of the skills which are learnt lead to observable changes in behavior. And generally, these theories include that kind of skill learning which do not require so much of reasoning and analytical thinking, and therefore these theories are called behaviorist theories of learning. Any learning is explained by behaviorist theories as a formation of a bond or a connection between a stimulus and a response. S bond R is supposed to be learning. Then what is new learning? New learning will involve the formation of a new bond between a stimulus and a response. So learning will be in the form of a series of S bond R, S bond R, S connected to R, SR, SR, SR bonds. So for a specific stimulus, the learner learns to give a specific response. Let us look at an example. This boy did not learn to run at the sight of a dog in the very first instance. After many, many experiences with different kinds of dogs, the person realizes which dog might bite and which might not, and looking at its behavior, he will either run or he will try to pet the dog. So this, to even to come to this particular response for that particular situation, the person must have undergone many trials and might have faced many situations in which he might have even made some mistakes also. So this kind of learning is very gradual, involves many trials, and the person makes many mistakes in the process of learning, and then towards the end, for a particular stimulus, he learns to give the particular response. And then we say learning has happened and a bond between a stimulus and a response has been made. This kind of learning is basically a process of habit formation. For anything to become a habit, it takes a lot of practice in the same situation. Therefore, many, many trials are undertaken by the person to learn, and a lot of practice is required. Three laws of learning operate in such situations: the law of readiness, the law of exercise, and the law of effect. What is this law of readiness? In order to make such persistent efforts, one should be motivated enough to learn. Maturation and motivation are both needed for this kind of learning. One should be physically and mentally mature enough for this kind of learning, and then after maturation, motivation is also a very important factor for a person to be persistent in one's efforts to reach the goal. This is the law of readiness. The law of exercise says practice makes a man perfect. Therefore, in order to master that particular skill, one has to keep on practicing it so as to avoid the wrong moves and to master the right moves. And then the law of effect says that when we give reinforcement, the individual gets feedback and accordingly modifies his behavior. So if the action is followed by praise, rewards, the connection between S and R bond strengthens. If that action is followed by reprimand or punishment, the connection between SR bond weakens. Thus, learning is habit formation, it is gradual, and three laws of learning, the law of readiness, exercise, and effect, operate in this kind of learning. In this kind of learning, we acquire almost all the skills, because any skill which is learnt involves a lot of trials, a lot of practice. Learning is gradual, and towards the end we master that particular skill. For example, the arithmetic skills like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division are learnt by this method. Even the language skills, listening, speaking, reading, writing, do not happen overnight. They all need a lot of exposure, persistent practice, and after that only we will be able to learn that particular skill. Even other skills such as learning to operate a computer, sports, driving, typing, arranging certain apparatus in the laboratory, arranging some books in a library in a sequence, and all this are some skills which are acquired gradually by practicing during many trials. Thus, behaviorism or connectionism or associationism involves that kind of learning which leads to observable changes in behavior and which can be explained in terms of a formation of bond or a connection or an association between a stimulus and a response. In this kind of learning, the learning is gradual. It needs a lot of motivation and even reinforcement for the learning to become perfect. Under behaviorism, you are going to learn two theories of learning: classical conditioning by Ivan Pavlov and Watson, operant conditioning by B.F. Skinner. Among these two theories, classical conditioning explains the lowest form of learning, which is a habit formation, but the responses are reflex actions, whereas operant conditioning explains how persons learn the desired behavior through reinforcement. Thank you.